Hey guys, hope you guys are having a great day as well as a great life out here.
That was like the least energetic. I like it. I like the energy.
I want to give him like a real casual one. I'm always,
every time I edit these, it's like, hey guys, hope you're having a good way. It's like a life.
So yeah, you gotta like turn the volume down and stuff.
Yeah, I do.
But not blow out their ears.
Yeah.
I started to give him a nice,
smooth one.
Chilled back one, yeah.
That was, nah, I dig it. And Wheel in the Sky, Journey, you saw the tongue title?
Yeah.
I can't talk.
Tongue title. Dude, we've been so terrified to hit Journey forever, because all like we know of him is like, don't stop.
Yeah. Please. Which, it's a good song, but it's not, I don't like it.
It's a good song, but say, like, when we're doing the music reviews here, it's like, is that the kind of vibe we want? But a lot of people have said for the past year, early Journey. And look, we got the freaking album on the wall.
We're going to trust it. We're going to trust the process.
It's time to do it. I'm feeling very freaking open-minded and excited about this. I just want to give you a little bit of rundown on my history of Journey. So in middle school, I was in chorus,
okay,
right? And we sang as a chorus team, Don't Stop Believing. So I sang that song probably like over like 500 times.
Yeah.
It's like ingrained. And the thing is, in the time period, I didn't hate it at all. I loved singing it every single time. I thought it was a great song, very charismatic. I like the chorus, so it's like, I dig it. And I'm really just excited to hear like what they had before that.
If you drink the Kool-Aid and you're in the moment, Don't Stop Believing is a great song.
Dude, it's so
as
good.
Soon as you go, is this cheesy? Everything crumbles. Everything crumbles.
Someone had to do it, and they did it, and they did it phenomenally.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's just facts.
Wheel in the Sky.
Let's do it, man.
Do it. Okay, great tone. Mm-hmm. Love the stereo mix. Oh, cool. Well, I guess it'll be this one. Yelling in the back? So high. We'll be right back. Wow.
Interesting. So interesting.
Great ending. Very, very unique ending.
I love how they changed that up. That brought it up.
Yeah. Yeah, because it has like some like this killer like energetic outro that you normally don't see. Like you normally like fade out and you're kind of like doing kind of what you're doing, maybe a little gnarlier, digging in a little bit more. You don't go like ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, like go in like a little harder.
No, that was really cool. Dude, that man had some freaking pipes.
Yeah. Yep. I mean, he should work at Lowe's.
For real, dude. Facts. He lamed good. That was phenomenal. His voice. Mainly at this point, I'm referring to just his voice.
Yeah. Yeah, I think great. His voice was incredible. Some of the best vocals I've heard in rock and roll, period.
Like you could easily, like, people, if they're not paying attention, can easily understate that.
But yeah.
It's, like, so good. Like, try and replicate that and, like, go to karaoke night and try and do what he's doing, and you will find out how hard that actually is.
Yeah, like, there are very few people who I think could attempt this in a karaoke and not do it, like, jokingly, you know?
Yeah.
This is very, very, very impressive vocals, very impressive guitar work. The drums were pretty constant through the whole thing. They weren't playing anything too crazy and really fit the pocket well. Did a great job. Like, just did a great job, period. The harmonies I thought were super interesting. Vocally, the melodies, like, it was put together well. Like,
yeah.
Don't Stop Believing is a great song. Mm-hmm. It's just, it's been overplayed. It's like not my thing. Mm-hmm. This feels like the same talent level, but in my ballpark.
Yeah.
So I dig it a lot.
Some great rock and roll here.
Some good rock and roll.
Well, I don't know how to say in my ballpark in terms of, like, I just feel like Don't Stop Believing, like, the songwriting, dude, it's so good.
Like, yeah.
The verses into the chorus.
Sure.
I don't know. It's hard to defend it these days, man.
Listen, if you love it, you love it, man. Like, some people like that. You're just one of those people.
I just think it sounds weird to say because I like this more than that in regard to it feels more, like, just nuanced and, like, fresh, you know, because I haven't heard this. I think if I really step back, I think I enjoy, like, just Don't Stop Believing more just because you can, like, pull back, you play it just on piano, and it still sounds great, or just an acoustic guitar, and it still sounds like you can still do it, and it's just, like, a great song.
I can guarantee you if you play this on piano, it will sound the same way.
It's probably
like, Wheel accurate. In the Sky keeps on turning, you're just playing piano, you're going to be like, oh, man, I fell in love with the song for a different reason.
God, that's probably true.
It's facts. 100% facts.
It probably is. Great, great song. Great song.
One of the things I just want to note, it's just like a small little detail that I really loved, is at the end, they kept it interesting vocally, is like they had, because there's like the main vocal lines, the wheel in the sky keeps on turning, that one, and then there's all this like background vocal stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I loved, as just a little taste, that they took out the main vocal and let you hear the backing vocals alone for a second. Then the next one, it was just the main vocals with no backing vocals. Then it went back to just the backing vocals with the main vocal. I thought that was really interesting. A small little touch that just like made you hearing the same line three times very interesting and unique all three times. So it's just something I noticed, like a little nuancey thing that like maybe you don't notice every time. And I might miss stuff like that in the future, but that was one where I was like, wow, somebody literally took the time to go, how do I make these three interesting, and did it in a very unique way. So
yeah.
I just want to address that because I thought it was great.
That's awesome. That's really cool.
Rating, what are we thinking?
I think B plus for me.
I think A.
I was like torn heavily between A and B plus. I think I like it a lot. I think, and this sounds bad, I just wanted the guitar solo to do a little bit more. I wanted it to be a little nastier. Just a little bit.
Here's, I think, the issue with the guitar solo.
It felt a little by the book.
I think the vocals being like, in the background, it kind of took away from the guitar solo. I get what he's doing, but literally the first second it happened, I was like, is that his voice? Because I was super impressed by the voice.
Yeah.
And then it like took away from me like enjoying the guitar solo.
Here's my thing. When the first guitar solo happened, I was like, it ended, I was like, that needs to be more, but it's okay.
Yeah.
And then like a couple, I think the next chorus, or some very soon after, guitar work came back and it almost felt like another solo. And I was like, they're fixing it. They're coming back in with the real solo.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They teased it, and then it was just like a bar and a half little thing. And I was like,
yeah.
So it's like, maybe it's just me. It's just me, personal like deals going on here. But I think B plus for this.
Fair enough. All right. Well, let us know what journey we need to do next. Clearly, this has been good. So
I want the early journey.
Early.
The raw journey.
Raw uncut journey. Let's do it. With that being said.